My dear friends, I don't pretend to have done great things, but I had been trying to do some things in a small way. What is it? See, I being a priest, committed to the vision of Jesus, I'm trying to kind of follow him. And he took a definite option for the poor. And his vision mission statement at Nazareth was gospel to the poor, good news to the poor. And today I'm afraid the church has deviated from this basic option, the fundamental option of Jesus, and it has gone to the priestly and the kingly ministry. I'm not against the priestly and the kingly ministry, but these two ministries must be seen against the background of the prophetic ministry of Jesus, which was definitely a continuation of the Yahweh's role in the Old Testament. Jesus continues the liberation of the poor and the oppressed. Therefore, there is a continuity. There is also a kind of a discontinuity. And this is the vision that spares me, you know, or that induces me to go to the poor. And actually, I must admit and say, when I go to the poor, I feel the poor are much more human. And they evangelize me. Instead of myself evangelizing them, they evangelize me. I learn a lot. After being in a seminary for 18 years, I went to a parish and I had to relearn, unlearn many things from the people in general, particularly the laity, and in a special way, the poor people, the Dalits, the downtrodden, the migrants, all these people, I think they taught me many things and they continue to teach me. And I am now working also together with people, other people in the civil society. And somehow I have a feeling that many of us think that church is not a civil society. Church is a civil society and we are citizens of this country. Therefore, we have an obligation to take up this dialogue in the civil society, and the space of the civil society, I feel, is shrinking. And we need to expand this. For example, the new education policy comes, you know. So what, I mean, we must enter into a discussion. When it came in 2016, we discussed this, we debated on this, protested against it. Therefore, the government had to shelf it, you know. Therefore, again, they have come. This is exactly what I am trying to do. Also participating in the campaign against the sterilite there, you know. In the beginning, people were divided, you know. The Vedanta company, Anil Agarwal, was trying to divide people on many counts, you know, on the basis of caste and the basis of religion and all that. But then finally, when the people saw how the sterilite was affecting the people with many kinds of diseases, beginning with the cancer and all kinds of skin problem and problems related to breathing and all that, they came together, you know. And unfortunately, we had to lose 13 lives, 13 plus 2, and now it's being closed. Therefore, my job is to kind of animate these people also outside the church boundaries, so that these people may have life in abundance. When especially the life resources are removed from them, maybe in the coastal area or maybe in the near Tanjore, you know, this hydrogapan. And I'm trying. I don't pretend once again to say I do great things, but I am trying to animate them, give social analysis to them. Also to some youngsters, 3 weeks ago we had a 3 days analysis for some young boys and girls from the coastal area to bring this awareness and take a kind of a political stand, so that the little that they have should not leave from them, namely their life resources. They have a right to life. And today, I think the religious leaders and the political leaders, we don't believe them very much. And therefore, I think these are the people, they have nothing to lose. Therefore, they are ready to come to fight against these structural injustice, both in the economic and political and social arena. And I just work along with them. Thank you so much.